I wish it was. Somebody fucking needs to change it to Run It Dawn.
Roll It Dawn.
Oh, Roll It Dawn. So it's Halloween. Hallows Eve, as they say.
Stupid holiday.
One of Danny's least favorite, I think.
I mean, I used to like it when I was a kid.
Okay, yeah.
Dressing up and stuff.
Oh, kids love it. What was your favorite to dress up as?
It was, everything was different every year, but.
Did you do the kiss thing ever?
Yes.
Because that was always fun.
I was Peter Chris. Peter Chris.
Yeah.
And then.
Did you go around singing Beth?
No.
That'd but, be awesome if you did.
But.
Boom.
Yeah, Halloween was. It was cool when you're a kid, because you're getting candy. But then when you get older, it's like. Somebody else knocks on my fucking door.
We always turn the light off.
Yeah, put the candy outside and just tell them when it's gone, it's gone. You know, put a sign.
No more.
You know what I mean?
First person, though, would come up and just dump it all in, right?
Yeah. If they were alone or the right kid, you will.
Yeah, I could see that happening.
Yes, depending on what it is. You know what I mean?
Oh, yeah. If it's Snickers and, you know, they got the fucking good haul. Yeah.
That's it's a bunch of mints. Ain't nobody going to do
candy corn.
Bunch of peppermints. Or, yeah, candy corn. Halloween, we put black in it. You know what I mean? It's like same old sugar.
Same old shit. Just tastes like sugar with, like.
But you know what?
I don't know.
Somehow on a candy corn. Whether white, orange, or yellow, black, orange, or yellow.
It's all the same color.
But.
I mean, on the same taste.
Orange part always tastes the best.
You think?
And it's the same crap, but the orange and the yellow seem to have a little.
A little pop to them.
Yeah.
I don't know if that's true. I do believe that if you eat them with peanuts, that's the way to go. Tastes like a payday.
Had no idea.
Oh, man, it's the only way to eat those. Mm. Only way. Other than that, you can just throw them away. You know what I do? I put them in the thing and give them out for Halloween. I was kidding.
Yeah, Halloween.
Nobody wants that. But what was the good haul was when you were a kid? I mean, you know, some people used to really hand out some cool stuff.
Yeah, and then back in Westwood, this neighborhood back here, they used to really, people used to go ham and like, you'd walk in the yard, there'd be music playing and somebody sitting over there and then
jumping out,
jumping
at
out at
shit
you.
Out of you.
Or they had two-story houses, which to me meant they were rich, which is not the case. Like, you know, it's just.
Now it's just a regular
neighborhood. They've got steps in the house?
Got steps to go upstairs?
I want to go over to Billy's.
And there's a bathroom up there?
Yeah.
How did they do that?
Yeah. That's where the rich people live, with stairs.
Yeah, stairs going upstairs.
Mm.
Steps.
Yeah.
As you say.
But
so,
I remember one, they had like a ghost on a wire, like a, what do you call them, wires that people
damn.
Swing on?
What do you call that?
Roll
zip line.
Zip line.
Yeah, zip line. Yeah. Thank,
like
you. Thank you.
And,
he,
and they'd be up in their windows on the top floor and take it down to a tree in the yard. So when you come across it, all of a sudden you'd be like,
that's shit badass.
No, it was cool.
Didn't I see that on episode of Brady Bunch or something?
You may have.
And it seemed like
they may have got the idea from there. But they were a creative bunch back in that neighborhood.
Now you just go buy it. Now you go buy it. They have these really cool things that just shoot it up on the wall, and it looks like some scary-ass shit. They've got ghosts, all kinds of stuff. We went into the store, the Halloween store, Because we like to do that and see what they have every year.
Yeah.
See what kind of slutty nurse, you know, or it's really gone beyond that. Now they have like a slutty barbarian chick, pirate girl.
Yeah.
It's like, but you have all this fake blood now, too. A lot of fake blood. A lot of cool stuff. You know, there's
11-year-old girl coming up to your door. I'm a slutty pirate girl. I'm a wench.
What are you? I'm a wench.
I'm a slutty wench.
It's a wench costume. Yeah. I think I saw someone in the
window. Yeah. Nah, you can't even got to worry about it. Kids are so fat and out of shape now. They be eating candy all year. It's no big deal.
It's like, we got to go walk around.
Baba. Hey, Baba, I want to go home.
This is too much. They don't even want to walk around.
Yeah, it's like,
we used to walk. I feel like I used to walk miles and miles when I was a little kid to get candy. One house after another, hitting the neighborhoods. You?
Well, we used to walk to the store. We used to collect bottles and go turn them in, get the change, and then buy candy. And collect
on Halloween. Well, we're talking about Halloween.
Oh, not on Halloween.
We're kind of talking about it's Halloween, man. I know you. I'm sorry, Danny doesn't like Halloween.
Halloween was cool when you were a kid because you got to stay up late. Now I stay up late every night. I blame it on Halloween and candy.
It's what he blames it on Halloween and candy.
Yeah,
staying up late every night. I haven't seen any candy in here. The fuck, you hiding it?
No. I don't really eat a lot of candy.
Oh, we better. Hey, welcome to WRBN Podcast. Danny Boone right here.
The most drastic, bombastic, podcastic situation that you've ever seen in your born days. I'm Danny Boone, Brad Darnell, podcast. What it up? What it up? What's up?
Back in the boombox.
Back in the boombox. Toot, toot.
It's nice.
It is nice.
It's very nice tonight. I just want to, you know, thank you for making it so nice. It was great. There's no Halloween dressings in here, but it's okay, you know?
Yeah.
You know, I hope when we get to Christmas time, we'll get a tree up and stuff.
Well, we don't do trees either.
You don't do, okay.
No, we don't do that around here.
Is there any holidays that are celebrated in? Is there any major ones you like?
Thanksgiving. We put a turkey out.
Eating ones, yeah. We put a turkey out for everybody. Walk by and grab hold.
Anything we can eat gets put out.
Okay.
Now,
that's coming up. Thanksgiving's not far away.
It is.
It's Halloween, so, you know, Hallow's Eve. That leads to, I used to like to go toilet paper houses, like. And me and my friends, we would just kill a house.
It's one thing I've never done.
It is so fun. I don't know why we used to have. I mean, we'd go in the middle of the night. And, you know, back then, you could. It was easy to get toilet paper at a lot of different places. You'd go in the McDonald's and pull them out of there and put them in a bag and walk right out. And we would just light up a house. I mean, people, I'm sure they. It was a very, very good job that we'd do. Wrap their cars. I mean, we would just. Killed or there was so much toilet paper they had to go. Oh man, these guys are artists. You ever do that?
No, I never. Never did
any vandalism.
I've used a lot of toilet paper, but I've never never thrown it in a tree.
Well, back in my day when I was a kid, we had so much toilet paper that we would throw it in trees.
Yeah, rich people. Now. Rich people rich rolling people. Houses. Meanwhile, we're over here using corn cobs. Just, I got a bucket rag of corn on a cobs.
Rag
just running them bitches.
Wow, do you think people use corn
cobs?
Yeah,
people did use corn cobs. My grandfather used corn cobs. But it's not the way you think. You don't shove it in your ass. No. You just take...
Why would you think that I would think that? I never said that at all.
When I was little, we used corn cobs. And that's the only thing I could think of. And I was a little kid, I was like, God, that must have sucked. Glad I wasn't born in the 1917 or something. You know what I mean?
Your ass would be tore up because you use a lot of toilet paper, I'm assuming. Jeez. Probably go through a lot.
But
probably,
now I get it. But the only thing is.
So what?
When you're wiping with the thing, I have to think it through. You're dragging. So I don't know if, you know what. You're dragging your situation.
Uh-huh. You are.
Do you just throw out the corn cob or do you flip it over and use the other side? And then keep trying to find a clean stripe on it until.
That's a lot of proofreading.
And then, just like toilet paper, you reach over, grab another one and make sure.
What are we doing with the corn cobs, though, that were being used?
Well, back then, they were outhouses, probably, and they just threw them out or did something with them. I don't know.
Chuck them as far as you can chuck.
Yeah.
I mean, I guess they decompose, so that's good.
Well, it's all organic.
Have a big pile of shitty corn cobs.
Yeah. Throw them in the garden for mulch or whatever they do.
We grow it from our shits. Yeah. These tomatoes are great.
Grown in the finest of proteins.
Why I don't buy roadside vegetables.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, they look pretty and orange from here. But.
These fucking tomatoes are way too big and juicy. I think they were grown in poop. So back the corn cob thing, I'm kind of, I haven't thought about that.
Now that's a Halloween trick. Yeah. Right there.
Now you know what?
Go up there.
Corn cobs are part of Halloween, so I guess that's part of the story, isn't it?
I didn't think.
Cobs?
I think
they're laying
part
around
of the decor. And I do not know why.
Corn cobs.
No, rotten corn or just bad corn with colors on it.
Just different colored corn. Yeah.
Is that a thing? For real? All of it ain't yellow?
I do believe it is a thing.
Hey, can you turn that AC on just a touch?
It's getting hot in here. Hot in here. You're breathing too hard.
I don't think so.
We'll get it on.
Hey, just put it on constant fan. It'll. Mm-hmm. You know,
yeah, it'll louden it up
till the front desk calls.
Yeah, till the front desk calls, and then there's gonna be trouble. They might kick us out of here. We'll see. So it doesn't sound too bad. So I think we're all good.
Yeah,
at least for a few.
It's the podcast.
So anyway, let's we've talked about let's see. Scarecrow was last week. Awesome song, Danny. I haven't been able to get this fucking song out of my head now. Thanks a lot. One of my favorite parts is the story that you told about it, which was cool. You said you went in and listened to it, and it was like Scarecrow. It's hilarious.
It was like, gong, 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 and then all of a sudden,
What about Mike in that song? What did he bring to that? Did he play the bass and guitar on that? Or do you remember?
I don't know. I know we went in.
Mike Hartnett is who I'm talking about.
Well, before Mike ever got there, we went in and Gary was just playing tracks. And at the time, anything, we was kind of hungry. But really, like a lot of the weirdest shit that he would play, we'd be like, yeah, let's do that. And I don't know.
I can
just
because
it was about being different, you know what I mean. Mm-hmm. So,
and you do a good job. I like your verse a lot. I've listened to it and
thank you.
It was very cool. The words, man. You wrote all your verse on there.
I spent 30 years in downtown, the face of a clown, stick for a spine, from a grandiose small town mind, and crows fly all around mine. And I remember because it was like. You know,
you were thinking about a scarecrow. It's
standing there. But I was sitting in my driveway writing because I used to sit in the garage a lot, and I was looking at the houses in the neighborhood because it was like 4 in the morning, and they're, you know, and I said,
they're off in the distance. So, you know, imagine if you were a scarecrow.
If I was a scarecrow sitting where I was sitting, type cool of shit. So
love it, man.
I don't know why I was trying to be a scarecrow, but maybe it was Halloween, and
you know what? That's a Halloween. That's kind of scary. Do you have any other scary songs that you guys do that you would even relate? That was like, that's kind of a scary song, other than King of Tweakers.
We did a song. We did a song that Rob Kelly has somewhere on tape, and we did it in a living room. Terrible recording. I think Steak did the track. And it was called Warm Breeze. And it was about nuclear war. And it was about watching the lady on the TV telling you that the nuclear war had started. And, you know, her signing off was, this won't happen again in a billion years. And
yeah, scary shit.
Yeah, it was
I like
crazy.
That one. I like that. Saturday, November 11th, rehab at the Premier, 7 p.m., Hickory, North Carolina. Chicago, Friday night, November 17th, rehab at the Ballydoyle Pub at 7 p.m., Aurora, Illinois. That's Chicago. November 18th, Saturday, rehab at the Music Factory at 7 p.m., Battle Creek, Michigan. Do you have any Halloween songs that you like?
You know, I like the Monster Mash. Yeah. It's a rap song.
How's it go?
Good, it's like,
how's it go? I mean,
it's the tip of the land, twist its way.
The chorus.
By the cryptic of fire. And Boris Karloff was mentioned in that song, name dropped. And
I thought you were going to say Boris Karloff would sang that. Is he in it?
No.
Anyway.
Tell them Boris sent you. That's what...
I want that probably sold a billion copies. It's here at every Halloween.
It was on Goofy Gold, actually, which was I had all those records, like just Goofy Gold.
Goofy Gold. Oh yeah. Had a bunch of different songs on it.
Yeah.
I can't think of any other Halloween songs, but how about movies? Are you're not into
scary now.
Scary. Okay.
Nah, I don't like to be scared.
Yeah. Danny doesn't like to be scared.
Fear is not that fun. I've noticed over the years. It's like I don't understand. That's why I never really could get all the way like into meth.
Cause it's too scary.
Yeah, it's like, hey, I'm a party. Man, this shit will leave you in utter fear for 3 days.
No, thank you. You hell be clutching for your life.
Give me. Look, man. I'm going to need some of that.
I will pass. Definitely.
I feel pretty peaceful. I'm going to need some of that mess.
I don't know, man. I feel like I want to ruin my life.
Yeah, what?
I'm feeling like maybe.
Why?
That's scary, though. That is scary. I hear you. I kind of like some of it's. I like some.
You like twists. Meth?
No. Movies. I'm not into meth. And okay. I'm never been a fan, man. I'm sorry. I shouldn't say I'm sorry. I don't know why I've said that.
It's not a.
Hey, Danny. I'm sorry. I'm not into meth, man.
Hey, man. Some people have their thing, man. I can't fault you.
Meth is not mine. Ever has been.
No,
it is. It's just what it is, I guess. But no, I was talking about movies. I like some horror stuff. You know what I mean? Some stuff is cool. The Saw movies, I thought they were the first few were really really good.
Saw one.
You would not like it. You would not like it.
What was that movie where that guy said, "Hey man, did you see Saw? Did you see Saw?" Guy's like, Yeah, all the time. We just go up and down on both ends. Oh, did you see? So, what movie?
Yeah, that's
was that?
The Office. That the is Office, Dwight Schrute. Yeah. Me and Moe's. Him and Moe's. Yeah, I see Saw. Me and Moe's do it all the time. It's great. I love Moe's. Love Moe's.
I love everything about that show.
when he brings a Ryan to his barn and opens it up and he's now you've got to fight fear and Moe's jumps out with a fear that says fear on his shirt.
Moe's
is a writer on the show. That guy's a writer on the show.
But you got me the Prison Mike sticker.
The Prison Mike.
Yeah.
Tara. The Prison Mike sticker. It's in the building now.
No, Prison Mike was the best.
Oh, yeah. Can we back you up against that wall, biatch?
Yeah.
That was the thing.
What was the other one that he said? He said, you'll be the Bella de Ball.
Don't drop the soap. Don't drop the soap.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That dude's great, man. In everything.
He is great, especially at that.
He plays Clueless better than anybody ever.
Man. I think some people just don't get it. It's so dry sometimes, and it's so good. Some people just don't get it, I think. And that's what's so great about it, too. It's Always Sunny reminds me of that, too. I love It's Always Sunny in Philadelphia. They do some really dry, crazy shit, too. Oh, that's awesome. They're off the rails, though, right? They're crazy.
But nothing touches Larry David.
Oh, Larry David. Seinfeld by itself. And then you get his show, which is called
Curb Your Enthusiasm.
Great show if you haven't watched it. Danny turned me on to it.
Yeah,
and thank you for doing that, man, because we love it. It's pretty, pretty, pretty good.
Yeah.
If you want to see all of these podcasts on video like me, come support us on Patreon. Just go to patreon.com and look for WRBN Podcast. You will see every episode on video and some extras. Come check it out. Let's jump back. Let's get back to the music. We're going on through this record, Southern Discomfort. And next song on here is Rattle My Cage. And everybody loves this tune. Great one. I love it too. The guitars on it are sweet. It's Mike, I'm assuming.
Mm-hmm.
Mike Hartnett.
I think so.
Okay. Really great song. Let's do you have any insight on it? How did this come about? It sounds like a song about rage. No, we're getting ready.
Oh, okay.
We're getting ready to hear it, but
all right. I didn't know. Well, I just wanted to get to that part. I had to remember the hook so that I could get to that part. Yeah, it's just about just being a complete asshole, basically. But there's a line in there that I got from Dee Dee Durden, friend of mine from high school, because we'd come to school stoned, you know, when you're a kid. you come to school stoned, and you know, even if you don't look stoned for some reason, when you first start doing it, you try to look stoned, like extra stoned. You're like, come in and like, hey man.
Oh yeah, we're really high.
Yeah man.
You know, we've
been hey man, what have y'all been doing? And then. But
really cool.
We'd be, but Dee Dee would always come in and be like, "Do you feel boxed in, drawn out? Like everybody's staring at you?" And every time,
I always remembered
that. And when we wrote that,
boxed in,
yeah, you feel boxed in, drawn out, like everybody's staring at you. She did that. Every time we get, you know,
so that fuck you up and you're all high. Yeah. Right.
Yeah. Why do people do that too? People are getting high to actually feel good. And then you've always got some jackass that wants to run up and try to give you a panic attack.
Oh, that's not cool.
Not that
Dee Dee
did that. She was just.
What's the line?
Do you feel boxed in, drawn out?
That's the line of the song.
Yeah, I'm boxed in, drawn out. Everybody staring at me, don't.
Yeah, it's great.
Yeah, that's great. That's all great. Right, that's on. Greatness. So how about them Hawks?
That's great. How about them Hawks this year? How about that? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah. How about the Big Three?
Basketball?
Yeah.
I don't know enough about it.
All right. I just wanted to see if you knew anything about it. Just checking, man.
All right, so I know Ice Cube.
It's Ice Cube. It's Ice Cube's deal. So
deal, and he's been, I think, beefing with some of the gatekeepers. I've heard.
Something going on. I just hadn't watched any of it, and I was just wondering what you thought about it because I know you like the NBA. But let's listen to Rattle My Cage. You ready?
Yeah, I think. Oh, just two.
What?
Brooks was, he was ready to do this verse. Like, I think, like
sounds like him.
In his mood.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? At the time.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we're having technical difficulties because somebody doesn't know the name of their mass, the name of their Wi-Fi network. So, hang on,
those in podcast land, I don't know very much stuff about computers. Wi-Fi, you ask? Oh, whatever.
You say I'm narcissistic and cold-hearted. Well, yeah, maybe. But I don't give a damn about you. This much is true. My vision's blurry and my thoughts are hazy, baby. I know I'm stupid, so I must be smarter than you. Keep your advice, leave me alone and don't. My life's a commode. I like my depression, a la mode. On the road, get off my back about my health. I like disease. I still be around where y'all are feeding trees. I don't want your speech or your sound advice. Don't like people who seem nice. Talking in my head like a family of lice. Just let me wallow in my rage. Don't clean up my droppings and don't rattle my cage.
Keep your advice, leave me alone.
Say, I want this hotel.
Yeah, you got to see some of my great beatboxing skills there. Real Dougie Fresh, this guy.
This, yeah, it's always great to see anything like that.
What is that? No, I just looked at the thing and it just just said no exceptions for rape or incest. And I was like, what? The computer.
That's why I don't mess with them. What do they call it? Election season coming up. This election season. So everybody's out there trying to. Yeah, everybody's out there trying to trash everybody else. It's the,
everybody's got their cause.
You know, everybody does have their cause, and there's some people that are on one side of the fence, and some people on the other.
You gotta feel bad though for the people who that is their cause, rape and incest. Like apparently they have a real problem with it in their past. You can't. No, for real. Like. That's your cause. You've got a situation that you need dealt with. You know, luckily. Luckily, what? I don't. Yeah, that because. Come on, man.
Yeah. Hey, that's perfect for Halloween special.
Politicians.
Oh, like, the worst.
You know, it's like, you know, fuck the economy. I'm the rape and incest candidate.
You know what? Who cares if you can't afford gas or food? Fuck you.
Yeah.
You better watch out for getting raped.
Yeah.
Now that's a big problem, too, but we got to eat and we got to have gas.
Yeah. Or, yeah.
Please.
You know, I'm just.
I'm just saying.
Yeah, me too. Why did you do your nose like that?
I haven't been doing bumps. I just.
The way you did it, though, looked real bumpish. You know what I'm saying? You look bumpish.
I am not doing bumps.
That joker said. I know. like a cat cleaning itself. What are you doing? What are you?
There's not a,
it's one of those.
There must be something in this room.
It's not in this room, buddy. It's not. It's not in this room. No. Somebody offered me some on the road this weekend.
Really?
Yep.
That probably happens all the time to you, Tom.
Well, we was right in the middle of the show. Was that song? Dude goes, hey, Dirt. I looked down there. And he was like, I got something for you after the show. I was like, all right, cool. And then after the show, I seen him. He pulled out this little vial, unscrewed it. And he was like,
I do a bump.
And I was like, nah, I'm good, dog. I don't really mess with that shit too more. You know, don't really fuck with it. And he said, there's no fentanyl in it.
Well, that's nice to know.
And I was like.
Does he have a tester?
I said, yeah. I was going to be like.
Oh, okay. Well, if there's no fentanyl, I'm in.
Like, damn, now it's tempting.
No. Yeah, it's so tempting now. There's no fentanyl in it.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, I'm sorry to say, but cocaine used to be good back in the day. You know what I mean? But now, I mean, why would you?
Used to be encouraged.
And it was, you know, fun. It was like, hey, want to get in the game?
Come on,
let's do this.
I don't want to go to school here.
Yeah, just do a bump. About half a line for you. You'll be all right.
Yeah.
No, but. They used to put it in Coca-Cola.
That's what they say.
And too bad we roam around for that shit. You know people are drinking like crazy.
Oh, my God.
You had a tall boy Coke tonight. It was packed with cocaine.
It cost 2 bits.
Did it cost?
Whatever a bit was.
Yeah, a bit.
Hey, pal.
It's 2 bits.
Here's 2 bits. Give me one of those Sony Pops.
2 bits?
Yeah, some of that sugar water.
Sugar water makes me dance. Imagine having a real Coca-Cola, old one, if it did have Coke in it. I do think that it has Coke. It had cocaine in it. That's why they call it Coca-Cola. But imagine you were dancing. Give it to little kids. I bet they were dancing around.
Dr. Pepper.
What's that about?
Doctor.
He's a doctor. It's all good. He's a doctor.
Pep.
Pepper. Oh, I see now.
Dr. Pepper. Hey, you need to He's the one that called Dr. Feel Good. He's the one that make you feel all right. Yeah, he's going to be your Frankenstein.
Dr. Pepper.
That's one of the lyrics of all time there. He's going to be your Frankenstein.
I know. I remember when it came out. I want to say it came out in the 90s. But yeah, he's the one they call Dr. Feel Good. He's the one that's
I want a bad song.
It's produced extremely well because I think it's Bob Rock and it just sounds great. And you've got Mick Mars on guitar and anyway.
What about Jeffrey Osborne?
You know, I heard Jeffrey Osborne had a new record out. Who is Jeffrey Osborne? Are you talking about the...
He had a great lyric back in the day. And I don't know how long...
R&B singer?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I don't know how long it took him to write it. But the hook was... And you woo, woo, woo. And you woo, woo, woo. And you woo, woo, woo. And you woo, 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 woo. And that was the hook.
That was the hook. That's it?
Yeah.
And you woo.
Sold... Millions.
What? Have you tried something like this?
I'm working on it.
Have you got your woo-woo on lately?
I'm working on it.
I know you've been doing some new, working on some new music.
Mm-hmm. That's right? What I do.
I know that's what you do, but we've all been waiting around.
Mm-hmm. You ain't the only one. Well, I ain't been waiting. I've been getting at it. I just keep creating them. I'm going to stack them up until there's so much work to be done that, you know, shit.
You're on it, though. New stuff is coming.
Stay
okay.
On it.
New stuff is coming.
Yeah.
Y'all.
I think we're going to call.
Stay with us.
I think we're going to call the album. I'm not going to say it.
Okay, don't say it. Well, can you tell me a little bit about after you listen to Rattle My Cage? There you go.
What do you want to know about it?
After you listen to it, what did you come out of it? I think that everybody feels like it's one of those you drive around beating on your fucking dashboard too. You know what I mean? Rattle My Cage.
It might.
Everybody, it's a big hit live. People love it live. Yeah, man, we always dug it live.
Yeah,
Or dig it live, I guess I would say.
It's a good song.
It's not deep or anything.
I do remember that I'm not into NASCAR at all, but back in the day, me and my boy Richie Swain used to watch NASCAR, and he was a big Dale Earnhardt fan before Dale Earnhardt died. And that was his dog, you know what I mean? And after, like, we put that song out and blah, 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 blah. And he used to always say, well, I just rattled his cage a little bit, you know, because they call him the Intimidator. He said, I didn't wreck it. I just got out there and rattled his cage a little bit, you know what I mean? And so we did Rattle My Cage. And then after that, his dad died, and it was just like a couple of weeks. Like, seems like we did a show in Tennessee, and they gave us a guest list, and Dale Jr. was on it.
Oh, shit.
And I was like, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and I was reading all the guests, and I was like, Dale Earnhardt Jr. was like, and I looked at, and I was like, that's a real Dale Earnhardt. And they said, yeah. And
The fake one.
No,
as opposed to the okay.
So we did the show. I didn't see him anywhere. We did the show, and then after the show, we're over there drinking with some guys from another band. And this guy walks up and says, "Here, man, somebody wants to talk to you." Gives me a phone. Dale Earnhardt Jr. He's like, "Hey, man. There was a rain delay in Pocono, and, you know, how much beer do we need? And,
some eastbound and down shit? How much beer we need?
That was at a different time in his life. It was right after his dad died. He was still a young
But so he couldn't make it to the show. He called you up and said, hey, man.
And he was sponsored by Budweiser. So, you know, I said, shit, let's get about 8 cases.
What's up with the way you did your nose like that?
You smell weird.
It's yourself,
you
man.
You smell like cocaine. I got a doo-doo.
You smell like, you smell minty.
That's because I have on some damn salve.
He smells minty.
I have on a liniment.
He's got the liniment on him.
A salve.
It's a salve.
An ointment.
It's a salve.
I know.
It's a salve. What did he?
I hate that word.
It's like a word that grandparents use. Did you put the salve on it, honey?
What you need is some salve. Well, just get some salve. Honey, get the salve. You know what I mean?
Put the salve on it. You know, it reminds me of that red shit. Remember that red stuff?
Mercure chrome.
Yeah. Put some of that on it. Anything you had on it, grandparent. Come here.
Yeah.
Put some of that on there. What the hell is that?
I walk around.
I was from the city. I'm like, what is this shit?
Mentholatum. What about Mercure chrome? What was that other one? Not mentholatum. I don't worry about it. Anyway, I want to think of it.
You smell minty, though.
Mm-hmm. And it's horse liniment.
He's got horse liniment on him, folks.
My shoulder hurts, and somebody told me that they put this stuff on horses when they run and stuff. And after they said it would help. So
you went to the farm store.
I went to the horse and buggy store. Yeah, the feeding seed. You know what I mean?
They got a buggy.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh no,
I'm just saying. I couldn't.
But does it work? Is it better than what's the stuff?
It smells like it works.
What's the stuff that Biofreeze? Does it work better than Biofreeze? Because Biofreeze is pretty good.
I've never had Biofreeze.
Yeah, you've used our Biofreeze.
I have.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, you've used our Biofreeze. Anyway. We should probably roll out, man.
There's a lot going on down in the town square. We're gonna get down there, and
we've got to get down there and start. There's a lot of candy to be got.
There's a big kegger on Dead Dog Run.
We are hitting the kegger on Dead Dog Run. Y'all meet us there, okay?
Hey, everybody's gonna be there, man. Hey,
Danny's coming as a white rapper again this
year.
Yeah. It's his best costume.
I think this year I'm gonna come as a schizophrenic brat kid and just kick all the food off the porch and be like, this is not good candy.
This is not organic.
Be the scariest fucking kid in the neighborhood.
Maybe you should. Sounds great.
You know
great.
What I mean? Like, just spoiled rotten.
Hey, like and subscribe on whatever platform you are listening on, please, and rate and share the show. Please rate and share the show. And thank you to all of our listeners in America and overseas, everywhere else too. We're worldwide, man.
All right, man. We're worldwide, man. We're going across the pond with this. I don't know if you guys saw the chain of lights in the sky the other night. Did you see those?
I did not.
Everybody thought they were UFOs.
Yeah.
It was really a train of our new network that we're putting up, and it's gonna be big. So watch out. The WRBN Network coming next.
Jump on it.
Yeah. Kimasabe.
Take us out of this, Danny.
All right. Follow us on all the socials. Come watch all of the podcast videos on our Patreon. We'll check you next time. Interests, challenges, circumstances. Circumcision.
Happy Halloween.